Mr. Excel Podcast is sponsored by Easy Excel. Excel In-Depth Chapter 34, SmartArt to Shapes. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill John. Well, you know, all the time we keep track of things in Excel. Right now I'm keeping track of these videos I'm creating. Here's all the videos I have to do, and I keep track of which ones are done and which ones aren't. So then I create a couple little formulas over here, figure out how many are done, just out of the column, how many I still have to go, and that's the count A of all the text over here, minus how many are done, the percentage that are done, and then a concatenation formula here. I like this one. Take that 57 with some text and then format the percentage in parentheses. So, you know, I get this little status of how things are going. And that works, but maybe I want something to motivate me a little bit more. Maybe you have a nice message to communicate. So I'm going to go to Insert, SmartArt, and let's go list charts or relationship charts. Here we go. Here's a arrow ribbon. Yeah, let's go with the arrow ribbon. Click OK. All right, now, what I really want to have is I want to have those formulas appearing here in the SmartArt. Unfortunately, SmartArt was built for PowerPoint, and they never thought about having dynamic values, so it just doesn't do it. Here's what I want you to do. I want you to build the SmartArt with just some dummy text. So, NN videos done, NN percent, and then over here, NN videos to go. All right, and what you're trying to do there is you're trying to just put in dummy text of about the right size. All right, and then do any formatting you want to do. Really important that you get this thing formatted perfectly the way that you want it. We'll choose a style here. I'll go with that one. All right, so we get things set up exactly like we want them, and then here's the trick. They actually added this to Excel 2010. I think because I complained about it in Excel 2007 so loud, I said, you really need a way that we can make this dynamic. And I hassled the people at Microsoft. I said, auto shapes have been able to have dynamic formulas for 10 years. Why couldn't you hook this up? They said, oh, it's more complicated than that. But they did show me a way to convert SmartArt to shapes. All right, so we have this SmartArt. I'm going to choose the SmartArt. And then here, they actually give us an icon now rather than the old trick. Convert to shapes, and now those are shapes. Okay, now that we have shapes, you see we have a text box there, and I want that text not to be static, but I want it to come from a formula on the sheet. So I click up here in the formula bar and type equal E5. Press enter. All right, and check that out. Now that text in the shape is coming from the formula. All right, over here. Click, and that's going to be equal E6. Enter. And then how it works, come down here, this is chapter 32. Let's... pick up, this is chapter 34. So I enter a 1 there to indicate that this video is done. And then how it works is if you update your model, we'll just enter some ones here. You see that it's not SmartArt anymore, but it was built using SmartArt, automatically updates to show the new values. So very cool to have dynamic SmartArt. Microsoft doesn't let you do it, but they very nicely added the convert to shapes. So that way it just becomes regular shapes. You can add cells that contain formulas as the source of all of those shapes. Well, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.